I attend is right across the Nairobi National Park. And every day as I am entering school and leaving school, I get to see these wonderful animals we call baboons, walking on the street, minding about their day. What else do I see? Quite a lot of plastics. I want to share with you an encounter I had the other day, whereby I was stalled in traffic as I was driving out of school and decided to look out of my window out of pure boredom, and I saw a family of baboons. One of them was tinkering with what seemed to be a plastic bottle cap, biting it, attempting to put it in its mouth. And even after I drove off, I still can't help but wonder what transpired after that encounter. I mean, did it swallow it, feed it to its child, feed it to its mother? And if this happens right underneath my nose, what else happens in a global perspective? So I did some research, and I found out that according to the Ellen MacArthur Foundation, there will be more plastics than fish in our oceans by the year 2050. Let me try to put it in a different perspective. Science has identified more than about 30,000 species of fish. That's around 3.5 trillion fish. Keeping in mind that that's only for 5% of our oceans, as that's the only part we've discovered. It would be an understatement to say that's a lot of plastics, right? I want to give you all a scenario to imagine in your head. Imagine you're at the beach taking a nice stroll, the sun on your skin, the soft, silky sand on your feet, and then all of a sudden, you step on a piece of plastic. I mean, it ruins your mood, doesn't it? But you'll probably go and continue to do whatever you do on holiday. But do you ever wonder where these pieces of plastic go? Or how they even got there in the first place? I mean, that same piece of plastic could be the one that you threw away when you're too lazy to find the nearest bins and hold your trash for 5 minutes. As you probably know, many marine animals die of plastics each year by either consuming them or choking in them and strangling them. And apart from marine animals, many other marine animals. But I mean, who cares, right? They're just fish. They're gonna be consumed later and we're gonna have a nice lunch. However, when that fish ingests that piece of plastic, it accumulates in their digestive systems. And then when you ingest that fish, the plastic also accumulates in your digestive system. And due to this, the average person eats about 5 grams of plastic every week. That's nearly the size of your credit card. I mean, it's scary, right? Or let's say you don't eat fish, but imagine if it was the other way around. Imagine if it was you, trapped in that piece of plastic, unable to get out. The plastics we throw away also break down into smaller plastics we know as microplastics. And these can find their ways into everyday resources, such as our tea bags, even our toothpaste. This just shows how disregarding of your waste so recklessly can come and bite you in the back. In the year 2017, my country banned the use of plastic paper bags. And this law was carried out very effectively. So I thought to myself, why can't we do the same thing we did for those plastic bags to plastic bottles? We just need an alternative. I mean, all of you probably know that plastic isn't biodegradable, but you don't have any other alternative other than that plastic bottle you hold so dear to you. So, this was just a mere thought, and it escaped my mind as I was still young. However, I recall watching a marathon in my family, and while they were shrieking in the background, I was focused on the athletes, specifically the time when they were being fed water. And instead of using plastic cups, they're being fed water through another medium. And I didn't think much of it at the time. I just saw it as a cool thing on TV and decided to move on with life. But as the weeks progressed, my friends and I kept talking more about it, and we decided to do some research. And we found out that this medium is called the edible water bottle, which is a tasteless and transparent sachet that's made out of calcium chloride and brown algae, and is sort of spherical and can be eaten and consumed. And whereas plastics takes like 450 to 1,000 years to decompose, these edible water bottles only need about 6 weeks. Just imagine, 6 weeks. Apart from that, they're also more cost-effective. The materials used to make them are cheaper than the materials used to make plastic. So if you think about it, it's a win-win. You're saving money and you're saving the environment. We just need to think of ways such as these that we can use to implement in our daily lives. I mean, instead of continuing to make those plastic bottles, we should think of other innovative ways we can give and pitch in to give, for example, the 184 plastic manufacturing companies in our country and to use these solutions instead. And not only should we stop producing more plastics, but think about what you could do as a person to reduce the amount of plastics you emit, the already existing plastics. I'll give you an example. My family and I often keep the fruits we eat in these plastic containers, whereby you put the fruits in the plastic containers, you put them in the fridge, when you're ready, you take the fruits, you eat them, and then you wash them and use them again. Or let me bring it closer to you guys. How many of you here have ever gone into your freezer and you saw a nice pack of ice cream and you decided to open it? It was calling your name. But the minute you open it, you see either fish or githeri or anything else inside that thing. Even the things you do that you don't notice make a change. It could be as big as making art or houses from these plastics, which I've seen people do, to the smallest things such as eating ice cream from a cone instead of a cup. The change starts with you, and I want to urge you to think of innovative ways which you can do to help reduce the amount of plastic you emit. To conclude, I'd like to leave you with a poem that I wrote. The trees are green and the oceans are blue. That may change. What are you going to do? The soils are nourished and your apples grew. That may change. What are you going to do? Maybe a turtle swallowed a straw, and maybe, just maybe, it drifted to shore. Earlier today, you had some lunch, sipped some drinks through a straw. I know you have a hunch. You see it looking so helpless, so down. Are you just going to stand there and fake a frown? And I may repeat the line that I've been saying all through, but is it necessary? I mean, it could have been because of you. Sitting here and waiting, while time is running out, just celebrating, whether or not we should start to try and play our part. The trees are green and the oceans are blue. That may change. What are you going to do? Thank you.